So we're out here on the bus in Pest. No. Okay, sorry. All right, once again. So we're out here on the bus in Buda. We just left Buda for the first time. No, you know what? I'm too lit. I'm too lit right now to even talk.
So,
how about you explain? Explain for the people where we are.
We left Pest, which is where we live, and we came to Buda, which is where Simon might go to work.
There we go. And now we're about to go to some waterfall monument that's
in
very
Buda.
In Buda, then walk over one of their famous bridges in Buda,
and then
to Pest. And then we're gonna go eat Hungarian goulash for the first time. So I don't want to hear nothing else. Everybody's in my comments saying, why didn't you eat the goulash yet? I'm going to do it. All right, okay, let's get to it. You excited?
Yeah,
let's go. Wait, what are the names you just gave the places?
It's Bougie Buddha and Poor Pest.
Yo, fortunately, you're still living on the poor side. But we're gonna make it to the other side one day.
Yeah.
Hopping off the bus, about to go make it to this monument right before the bridge on the other side. Wow. That's really cool. And the mist of the water sort of hits you, even when you're standing over here on the sidewalk, kind of far away from it.
Yeah.
Very cool. So you can walk up and around this place. I think it's called the Citadel or something like that. It looks like some old fort, but the waterfall is making me have to pee, so I can't do it today. We're gonna do this next time though. Really cool statue on top of the hill over here. Oh, and now we're crossing this nice bridge back into Poverty Pest. This is the view over the Danube. When it comes to walkability and being able to move around the city using public transport and that sort of things, Budapest does rate very high. But something I have to say is that when you buy these tickets to use them, half of the time nobody checks them. We just got on the bus and I bought a day pass and nobody has asked me to tap it or use it or anything like that. What do you have to say about that?
I say welcome to Europe.
Wow. Wow. Every building here makes you feel like you're in a Wes Anderson film. What's the right way to say it?
Wes Anderson, that's not Anderson.
Sitting at the dock of the bay. There's no way you can't come here and feel some type of way about the architecture. You know you're in Europe when you see kebab. The church bells do ring in Budapest. Look at the angels. Going from above ground to underground to cross the street. Welcome to Central Europe. No, straight ahead.
No, we have to cross the street.
And up we come, back above ground. Are we almost there, Miss?
Yep.
Wow, look at that. I thought it was a masjid, but Acti said it's a synagogue. It's because she's Jewish. Almost there to where we're going to try this goulash. Look at the cool painting. Is that Salvador Dali? All right, so this is where we're going. The Hungarian restaurant called Drum Cafe. Langoš and goulash, their specialty. Nice little setup. Let's sit outside and pull up. All right, these guys look very nice and helpful.
So they have one inside of the bread too.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is what their menu looks like. Interesting, the alcohol starts on the first page. And then, yeah, a lot of spirits, drinks and that sort of thing. For anybody watching, about 355 Hungarian florint is about $1. So do that division if you want. A lot of drinks and coffees up front, cocktails, that sort of thing. But then we get to the food. This is sort of what they have, premium Hungarian menu. This is the best of the best, starting at 4,000 Hungarian florins. Poppy seed cake, that's very interesting, never seen that. Budapest beef menu starts here, okay. But I'm probably gonna get this. Bean and beef goulash soup, bean, beef, thin smoked sausage, vegetables and sour cream for about 1,790 florins. But they have a lot of things. They even have a kosher menu, which I guess would also be the halal menu for the people out there. All right. And yeah, that's what it looks like. Oh, they have chivapi too.
They have a lot of stuff.
So, don't say Hungary is not the Balkans. If they're serving chivapi, this is the Balkans. Cholent. I wonder what cholent is. With pearl, barley, boiled egg, and smoked goose breast. Interesting. That's too fancy for me. Okay. Yeah, this is what it looks like. A lot of good food.
Hungarian beef goulash.
Hungarian beef goulash? Okay. Yeah, I'm going to get the Hungarian beef goulash with beans. Yeah, this one. Bean and beef goulash soup. Okay. Does that come with bread? Okay, yeah. Yeah, spices too, yeah, please. So far, I've been very impressed with Hungarian food. Their bread is good, cheese is good. They eat a lot of good meat. They make it well. Looking forward to trying this. I don't think I'll be disappointed, but I'm gonna give a real honest review as soon as I try it. So far, what do you think of Hungarian food since we've been here?
I like it. There's a lot of diversity in terms of the food you can find here, but if we're thinking specifically about Hungarian food, I think it's meaty, it's savory, it's spicy. And I like it so far.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of good bread. I think they make bread really well here.
Yeah, they do.
All right, so the food is here already. Came very quickly. That's real soup. I'm not sure if goulash is supposed to be soupy or thick. I don't know.
I feel like it should be soupy.
Okay. Anyway, smells very good. Smells very brothy. A lot of MSG in it. It's kicking. Let me try it. How was it?
The juice is good. Yeah? There's a bit of spice in there, but it's a very tiny bit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very beefy. I like it so far.
Yeah? It's good?
The rice. And I have like little noodles here, like pasta.
Yeah? Yeah. How does the actual meat taste?
I didn't try it. Very tender.
Very
tender. Yeah, it's really good. It's not like overpowering.
Okay.
And I still can taste the meat itself.
All right, nice. All right, so let's get to it. They brought the bread out with some sauce. I don't know.
Is that hot sauce?
Might be hot sauce. It's red. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I want some of that too.
Ooh, that's actually really hot. That's really hot. Okay, all right, anyway, that's not gonna mess up the review. This bread feels like cornbread or cakey. It doesn't feel like bread like you would just grab, like French bread. It doesn't feel like French bread. It feels very soft and moist. Very good by itself. Let's try it though. Let's dip it into the broth of the soup. Oh, that feels like home. That feels like chili. It tastes kind of a chili flavor, like very mesquite. Yeah? That's very good. Oh, I got some on my fingers. Finger looking good. All right. So far, the goulash is kicking as far as the flavor. Look at that beefy, big chunk of beef. We're gonna bite right into that. Mmm. Okay, so it is very tender. It falls apart right into your mouth. It's just, it feels like it's been basting in that broth for a long time. It's very hot right now, as in the temperature, so it's hard to like eat it and savor it, but it is very good. I suggest you start with the bread first, you dip it, just enjoy that broth, and then you get into the soup after. It's very, very good. there's a lot in here. There's potatoes, there's beef, there's carrots. But yeah, the flavor is very chili-ish, like chili, like good Texas chili. That's how I would describe it. It's good.
All right, she's trying mine.
Yours definitely tastes like fattier and also like more spicy, like there are more spices in there, not just as in like hot spicy. But that's really good still.
Yeah, definitely.
Stop. No pizza.
I saw a pizza over there. Get that pizza over there. Right on that table. Back to me. So I'm going to try hers right now. Just the broth, just the flavor of it. And that's a good soup. That's like a solid soup, but that's more of like a soup you could make at home. It has like that chicken noodle like type of flavor to it. Just very basic, just very, you know, beefy and brothy. And it's not like this one exactly. It's still good. Both are good, but I'd be happy ordering it. But this one is hitting more.
If you're a real one, you know you do this. Break that bread, drop it in the soup, pick it up with the spoon. And enjoy. But that's only for the real.
So I ordered a beef and bean soup, and at first I thought the beans had already like dissolved or they were small, but then I pulled up this in the spoon and it looks like an alien egg. Look at that.
Wow.
What is that? That is, oh, hey, you got too excited. You gotta try that bean. Oh,
don't
wait.
Don't spill it.
It's a good bean.
It is.
Yeah.
I never had that.
I've never seen a bean this big. Look at that. Never. Mmm. Very good though.
If your goulash soup don't look like this with the bread inside, you ain't a real one. But Acti, tell us what the soup should have had.
I thought it would be perfect if it had like whole garlic cloves that have been like stewed and cooked inside. That would have been so good.
I agree.
Oh, she putting the bread inside too? Oh, she a real one. All right, so here's my review of Hungarian goulash, right? So this isn't the first time I've had goulash. When I was in Serbia, I had goulash for the first time, and I really enjoyed it then. It was a bit thicker then, but it definitely did not taste like this. This is a much more rich flavor, much more fulfilling flavor, tantalizing, everything like that. But the only thing is that I'm not a big soup eater, guys. Like, I don't just go out to restaurants and say, let me get the soup. And, you know, I'll eat soup if my wife makes it or something like that. But soup isn't like my go-to. And I don't know if this is the only type of goulash, because this is the soup kind that I ordered today. Maybe there's another type that's a bit more thicker or something like that. And I would probably enjoy that a bit more. I'm not saying that this is bad at all. It's just like, if I go out to eat, I don't usually order soup. But this is very good. It will probably be better at a different time instead of summer, because right now we're eating this in the middle of the summer where it's like 25 degrees and I'm hot. And this is like a hot dish that's warming up my body. But in winter, this will probably be perfect. It reminds me of like the Tunisian dish, leblebi, like a winter dish that fills you up and touches that inner part right here. You know what I mean? It like really warms you up right here. But I give this overall a 9. It's a great dish. It's just not for me right now in summer. And it'll be something I probably have to be fed rather than order. You get what I'm saying? I hope that makes sense.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
So, you want to review?
I am a soup eater. Soup is a big part of like traditional Turkish dinner. Every winter we have soup and then the main dish. So, this is like a soup that could be eaten as a main dish, which I love, because it fills you up. Like, I'm full right now and I didn't even finish my soup yet. But I give this a 9 too, because I know that there could be some things that you can add inside that will make it like more flavorful. Maybe some like herbs too, I guess. I don't know, some greenery, but yeah, overall it's really good. And I also really like this hot sauce. It has that type of hotness that comes later after you eat it, like 1 minute later. It comes and it kind of boosts your taste buds, if that makes sense. But yeah, like, probably I'll be eating this a lot during the winter, and
I'll probably be forcing Simon to eat it with me.
All right. Okay, so I finally tried the Hungarian goulash. Me and Acti both reviewed it. We enjoyed it. Y'all shut up about it. Don't leave no more comments about the goulash. Only under this video. So this right here is the Langoš poppy seed cake. And it's supposedly a traditional Hungarian dessert. We're going to try this too as well. Go ahead, you first. Oh, you're not feeling it. You're the one who made me order it. No. You have to like it.
It's nothing too spectacular. It tastes like some vanilla sponge cake with poppy seeds. And then some like cream on top. And there's some lemon flavor there. And that's basically it.
Interesting.
It kind of feels like you baked a cake and then just put some milk on it. But it's not bad. You know, it's just nothing like spectacular or, you know, it's not baklava.
Y'all have to remember, she's bougie because Turkey makes some of the best pastries in the world. So she's going to be very particular about this.
Okay, there's some cream there. Like patisserie cream. But it's good. Okay, that's better. I only got the cake part of it first. It's like a profiterole roll with some cream and poppy seeds on top. Without the chocolate.
She reviews pastries and sweets and desserts like Dame Drops reviews fried food. It was like, you know, there's some two eggs.
You can try it.
Alright, go ahead, get me. For me, I'm not that particular about pastries. I either like it or I don't. That's it.
This is something like you would put together.
Wow.
Late at night for me. And you'd be like, here, Acti.
That's really good. For me, it's like it reminds me of a donut. I'm gonna be more simple. Tastes like a donut, guys. It was chopped up and they put icing on it and melted it in the microwave for like 15 seconds. That's all.
Yeah, it's like deconstructed donut.
For me, it's good. I'm not sure about the poppy seeds. I'd be fine without the poppy seeds. That's the only thing. I like it.
I like poppy seeds. What do you rate it out of 10?
I just got the lemony flavor you're talking about. And lemon for me is not really my go-to for sweets. So I give it about 7. It's a 7. It's all right.
It's 6 for me.
It's a 6 for you. Well, you better eat it. Go on, girl. Get to grubbing. All right, so for everything that we ordered, it was 7,601 Hungarian florins. You divide that. Well, here it is in euros. That's about 21 euros and 72 cents, or about 22 US dollars. Hey, Hungary is not cheap, but we did kind of order a lot. But there are places that you can eat here for cheap and regularly. Like, they have a street food culture. But going out to restaurants here in Hungary. Why did I say Hungary? Because I've been drinking that Saproni, homie. But no. Eating out at restaurants in Hungary can rack up over time. But if you go to the bakeries and other places, you know, you can be okay if you're eating out in the street food. That's my opinion. All right?
Also, in their supermarkets, like Aldi, Little, and Spar, you can find like whole meals ready, like salads, big sandwiches, gyros, and all sorts of stuff, sushi. So you can like go there and, you know, get one meal out of the way for cheap.
Good advice. All right, this is not a paid endorsement. We keep it real. This is a real, real review. So we ate goulash for the first time at Drum Cafe here. It's not hard to find. If you type it in on Google, Drum Cafe Budapest. I enjoyed it. The food was very good. Service was actually really good. They were very quick. And it was clean. I went to the bathroom in there and the toilet was sparkling. And so that's always a good thing. When they keep a clean toilet, they keep a clean kitchen. So overall, I give my experience here a 9. The only thing that makes it bad, you can't smoke even in the outside areas. Come on now. Anyway, what do you think?
Anyway, when I first saw it on Google Reviews, it doesn't have that good of a review, but actually it was really good. I don't know why the, you know, score was like that, but I really enjoyed it too. So I'll give it a 9 as well.
All right.
It's a good place to start tasting Hungarian food because they have a lot of options. A
lot of options. A lot of interesting langos, goulash options here, sandwiches, pizza. Everything looked good, and what we ate was good. So, yeah, 9. Solid. All right, let's go.